All right, so I've started the video, gentlemen, and anything you say now can and will be used against you because it is now being recorded. Anyway, okay, so welcome. I'm going to fly from Balakula to Steward. All right, it is going to take probably about 2-3 hours. Let's quickly see if I can work it out. Yeah, it's a long time. You don't have to sit here the whole time, Uncle John. It says in the planning, it says 1 hour 49 minutes. So I actually overestimated it. It's going to be just under 2 hours.
I definitely won't be watching that all the way through.
No, that's fine. You can go and make your food or whatever you need to do. So yeah, I'm just going to mosey along. If I fall asleep, I'll mute my mic as well. You know, I'll just open prayer, I wake up before I need to land or something. I'm literally doing this just to complete this tour now and get it out of my system, so you know how it is. Just want
to
get
there. How many more
legs have you got to do? From Steward, we need to go to Ketchikan and then to Juneau, so it's like 3 legs, including this one, okay. I think. And then it's done. Then I can concentrate on doing other stuff.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Right, I'm in need of my lamp so I can see my parking brake is set. It's very dark here. Right, let's push those ones a little bit forward. Get some power. Get some fuel inside. There we go. That should be enough. Alright, so I've already done the loading and all these things behind the scene. We don't have to worry about that. And then we can try and start this baby.
Back in a couple of minutes.
Wow. We actually went and stood on our backside there. Right, so this thing can warm up a little bit and we can get into the swing of things.
TOS, system test okay.
Oh, the magnetos are working.
Approaching burn station. I think you want to put the cost index up to 500.
I think so. I think that's a brilliant idea. Are we there yet?
Are we there yet, Dad? Are we there yet?
Already? We've been flying for 5 minutes.
It feels like hours.
Yeah.
I don't want to meet me.
Those granite clouds are getting a bit close. We need to keep an eye on them. Very inconveniently placed Cloudy on the left. It looks like we're going through a gap there. I had a bit of a problem with this 750 GTN GPS. It didn't work in P3D 5.2. It gave me so much hassles, I just never got it working. And now in 5.3, it's working like a charm again. It's really nice. Eh?
Yep.
So yeah, now we've turned back, we need to go down that valley to land, and then it'll be over, so happy days.
If that was a Zeebo, you wouldn't forget about it. There's not been an airliner in the last few years, kind of went past its destination. Where's it gone? I'm sure it was somewhere in Europe where the pilot just went way past the destination airport, forgot about it.
I'd heard about that.
Did they fall asleep or something like that?
Well, whatever they did, they managed to either wipe or run out the cockpit voice recorder for long enough that there was no evidence of what actually went on.
Sneaky bugger. Sorry folks, we fell asleep, we'll need to come back and get to the airport.
In our Cessna 210, the one I showed you the other day that we flew, we had a very rudimentary autopilot. It wasn't as fancy as this. It could keep you basically flying straight and level. But I don't think it ever had any option to actually follow a flight plan, and it just wasn't that good. But we never used it because we were always worried, you know, what happens if you fall asleep? Yeah, it's just you don't want to wake up when you hear brr, brr, and you feel that sinking feeling, you know, that's not when you want to catch a wake up.
Especially when you're in the middle of the mountains. Where
to
land.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm sorry if there's a runway about, you can bring the planes down with power.
You can, but you have to be extremely lucky to be in the right place at the right time, you know, and if you fall asleep, and you go over the country's border and you end in Botswana or Zimbabwe, you know, in Zimbabwe they'll shoot you down. You know.
I need you.
Maybe even Botswana too. I don't know what they'll really do, but you know, it's it is crossing an international border, you know, so you could be in for a treat on the other side. You could sit for 10 years in jail there because they think you're smuggling something or something, you know.
It's not going to be nice anyway, Nico, is it?
No.
They're not going to welcome you with open arms. Thanks for flying into your company illegally.
I'm gonna try maybe do that. Okay, what I need to do is just get the fuel pump on, bring my throttle to idle. There's flaps one. But we're still not gonna make it. We're almost on top of this runway. It's somewhere there where the mouse is. We're just too high. We're still gonna have to probably overfly it and come back. It's somewhere here, man. It's just right here somewhere. Can't really even see it from here, but these flaps too.
Yeah, you'll drop like a rock now.
We're gonna try. See. Damn it. Can't believe I over flew this airport so far, but anyway. So what do we usually say, children? Do not try this at home. and dear Google, dear YouTube, this is just a simulator. It's not really dangerous. Please don't demonetize this video.
Really?
You could chuck some S-bends in as well if you fancied and really push it to the edge.
Yeah. You can do a barrel roll as well. You know? I won't really do that. But anyway. Oh, Mac, you know Queenstown in New Zealand?
Yes.
They demonetized one of my videos from January 2020 or 2019. I can't even remember. It was an old video. And they said to me it's demonetized because of dangerous activities. I actually had to appeal it and explain to them it's a simulator. It's not dangerous. And it took them like 48 hours to restore the video and the monetization. No, they flagged it. They sent me this computerized message demonetized for dangerous activities.
Does it take somebody to say something before that happens?
No, that's automated. I don't know. That must be some AI automation. And it's when you appeal that it goes through to a human being, you see. And that's when they usually pick up somebody's talking, some bully there.
That's crazy, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not too keen on this AI story because you can't argue with AI. AI's got a yay and a nay. There's logic, but no empathy. There's no common sense. There's nothing, you know. It's actually scary.
Hammer beats AI. Hammer will win every time.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you can't win all of them. One of my friends is big time into AI. He's a programmer for one of the big banks in South Africa. AI is taking over big time.
Yeah, that's how they get your YouTube on, your videos on YouTube, innit?
Mm.
Algorithms and all sorts.
Yeah.
Terrain ahead.
Yes, Betty. We hear you, Betty.
Bitching Betty.
Yep.
Are you allowed to say that nowadays? Is that?
Oh, I don't know. Well, you're not talking about the human being, so you shouldn't be censored for that. It's just the freaking name of the computer program.
Oh, I thought that was my co-pilot's name.
I've never ever landed from this side. I don't think they'll ever do it in the real world, eh? But who knows? I don't know. See, there's the airport there in front of us. I think that's the airport.
It's an emergency.
Yeah.
That scenery looks nice.
Yeah, it is, eh? Yeah, I think we're going to make it.
Yeah.
Nicely done.
Well, he's not landed yet, Paul.
Yeah, well, we did a nice descent. Nasty.
It's no over to the fat lady sings, as I say.
Yeah.
I've got the cigar waiting.
Excellent.
Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead.
Shushman.
Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead. Pull up.
Here's the runway.
Terrain ahead. 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 Terrain ahead.
Shut up.
Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead. Terrain ahead.
Thank you so much.
And when he lands here, he's going to find that they haven't got any fuel.
I'll phone Uncle John. He can bring a few turkeys for the guys with some fuel.
Surely I've got some moonshine up there. You can just pack the tanks.
Yeah, we'll make a plan. Feels like I've got a bit of a crosswind, yeah. Eh? I mean, look at my crabbing. It's I'm trying to fly straight. It's not doing it.
Yeah.
Those rudder pedals again, eh?
Yeah. Ugh. It looks like I have to calibrate them before every flight, but I'm too lazy.
Well done, man. Nice one.
Yeah, we made it. Nobody died. I want to turn around. I don't want to park on this side. Ugh, come on. This was one of the first sceneries that Orbex made, where they put stones like this. Look at the stones lying all over the place.
Nice.
It's very, very high detailed. This was one of their very first, very high detailed airports.
Looks realistic with the cracks and the stains and the kind of edges and that.
Yeah. There's Grandpa waiting for me.
Read the newspaper.
Yeah. Oh, thank goodness we made it.
A bit chilly to be opening that window, Nico.
Well, it's 18 degrees now. It's not that bad.
All right. Oh, that's all right. That's summer time in Scotland.
Yeah. Right, so let's have a wee look around. Hello, Grandpa. I hope you've got fuel, sir.
What's he reading, Nico? Is there anything in that newspaper? Oh, there's headlines.
Yeah, we can't really read them.
Nah. That's cool as running, though.
Yeah. Look at the truck in the house there. Wow.
It's really detailed, eh?
Very detailed. See, now the first thing that goes through my mind is, what on earth do the guys do here that make it worth their while to stay here? How do they earn a living? How do they get money?
Gold.
You think?
Possibly. Alaska's full of gold. I mean, if they're staying near a river, there's a good chance.
Well, there'll
be gold.
You've seen huge rivers all over this place, so it's possible, I suppose. Anyway, thank you guys for watching, and sorry I forgot about the aircraft and I had to come save it at the end, but it brought a bit of fun with it. So anyway,
we made it.
Yeah.